Good day. My name is Ugochukwu Ukwebu. In this video tutorial, I'm going to show you how to configure and host a static website on Google Cloud with cloud storage. I think every developer should have a domain name and website. They are the foundation of your personal brand and your method to communicate with potential employers. You can use your personal website to showcase your skills and portfolio of projects you have worked on. Google Cloud Storage offers you a quick, easy, and inexpensive way to host your static website. In this tutorial, I'll show you how to create a cloud storage bucket and configure it to serve your website files. I will show you how to upload and set permissions on the static files for your website. And then we're going to test the website. The prerequisites for this video tutorial that you need to follow along is a Google account. With a Gmail, you can set up your own account on Google Cloud platform. So let me begin my presentation. All right, so this is my Google Cloud Platform console. So to start, we just go to the left of the screen. Among the services, we find cloud storage, we click on it, and then we click buckets. All right, so when the screen opens up, we create a bucket. So here, your requirement is that you give it a unique name. So let's say it's a website. I'll call it www.mycomputershop.com, right? Okay, but because I won't be verifying the domain name here, I will just name the buckets my computer shop-com, right? This is for demonstration purpose, but in real life, you'd name it, if you intend to name it at an actual website, you're going to get a domain name, register that domain name, verify it with Google that you own the domain name, and then you name the bucket your domain name. But for verification, for demonstration purpose, we'll use mycomputershop.com. So I click continue. It asks me, where do I want to locate the bucket? Recommended is multi-region. That's what you want to use when you want to get to have a standard website. But of course, because once again, this is strictly demonstration, I'm going to just stick with region, right? Yeah, I'm fine with US East 1. So I'll click continue. Now I'm supposed to choose a class, right? So let's see, let's scroll down. Yeah, standard class is fine. So I'll click continue. Access control, recommended is uniform to ensure uniform access to all objects in the bucket by using only bucket level permissions. That's fine. It suits our purpose. So I click continue. Protection for now. None is fine. So let me go ahead and create the bucket. Okay, so we have a pop-up coming up saying public access will be prevented. Yeah, it's fine. Let's enforce public access prevention on this bucket. Though later we're still going to unenforce it because we want the files in the bucket to be publicly readable, right? It's our website, and the intention is for it to be globally viewable and seeable. All right, so we have our bucket set up. So the next thing is to get the website files that we're going to host in that bucket, right? So where do we get it? Now, at this level, of course, you've gotten your site content. So maybe you've there's a developer or a developer team, full stack developers. They've built your website, your static website, and then so this assumes that it's ready somewhere. So we go pick it up, right? So for this demonstration purpose, I have a static website which I've uploaded on GitHub. So I'll pretty much go to GitHub, github.com, yeah, computer shop 3, right? So I have. Yeah, so this is a static website ready. So I pretty much download it as a zip file. So once it's downloaded, I show it in folder. It's in the download section. So let me cut it and paste it on my desktop. All right. So let me unzip it. Yeah, it's okay. Yeah, so these are the files that will compose or that will make up our website, right? So I can say, let me even test it. I can test it on my local machine by pretty much taking this index page and dropping it on the browser, right? So this website, static website, is now saving on my own local machine, right? It's pretty much working. Everything is working as fine, right? So it's been developed, it's tested, it's working locally. Right. And here you also know the essence of a website, a server on the internet. As it is on my local machine, I'm the only person who wants to see it. Right. Why it's going to be a website is because we want everybody to see it. So we take the files and we host it on a publicly available computer. In this instance, our Google Cloud Store. We set it up and then we advertise to everybody that, oh, go look at our website on this public machine that is on all the time and that is highly available. Right. So we go back to our cloud console. We already know that we have our website files in our local environment. So here, the next thing is we upload it to our bucket, right? So I'm in the bucket. It's empty right now. So let me go upload my files. Okay, I think let me upload a folder. I have it in desktop. And be sure I'm looking at the main one. It's computer 3. Yeah, so this is it. I know the file structure, so I'll put everything I need for the website. So the images I believe are up. Okay, select folder. Okay. I need the images, right? Have I uploaded it? Okay, images go up. Yes, I want to. And then there are some, that was a folder, images folder. Now I want to upload some files, right? These are the contents of the images folder. Now, I want to upload files. I need the error page. And I need the index page. I don't need the README page, right? The README, it's let's see. Let's see the content. The README had a content. The content of the README page is what we see here. It's a description of what the website files that you find on my GitHub repo says, right? You say it's a demo website for a computer shop. This is a demo website for a retail shop. In this case, a computer shop. It was built using HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. This code can be downloaded and used by anyone cutting their teeth in website design. Feel free to modify it and make it your own. A functioning version of this demo website can be seen in that URL. So if you're free, go look at it and see what it is. Fully functional version of that code base. And then, yeah, you can take it up. So, but that's what this README does. We don't need it up on our server. So, So basically, now we have all our files in our bucket, right? So at this point, our buckets and it says our bucket is not publicly viewable, right? The way it is set up right now, it's you can see, look at this, right? The files of our buckets not publicly accessible. You can see this here, right? So nobody can see it. So basically, for it to be publicly accessible, we are going to consciously do it by ourselves, right? So this is one of those security features too of the cloud, right? The cloud platforms, they try to integrate security by default. So by default, the bucket we've set up is not publicly accessible. So we could you could decide to store confidential data in your buckets, right? And grant access to only those who you want to access it, right? So that's by default. So if you want to now make it publicly accessible, it's something you're going to do consciously, right? So now it's a website. We want everybody to see our website. So, and we in design, we didn't put anything we don't want to be disclosed, right, to the world in our pocket, right? So we want the things we put there are things we want people to see. So deliberately, we're going to make it publicly accessible, right? So to do that, we click on this permissions tab, right? It tells us that it's not public, right? So we're going to remove public access prevention, right? So we click that, right? And yeah, it gives us a warning, right? By allowing public access, any permissions that has been previously granted to all users will be restored. All right, so yeah, so we confirm that. All right, so it's publicly viewable, right? But there's still one more thing we need to do. Okay. All right, so I need to scroll down there. All right. So one more thing, right? I want to add permissions there. Okay, I need to something I'm looking for there. Okay, grant access, right? I click grant access. New principal. I type all users, right? So I click all users, right? And then I have to select a role. We have to be very careful here, right? To what role do we want to grant all users? We give it storage object viewer, right? So just storage object viewer is all we want to do, and then we click save. Yeah, still, warning again. Are you sure you want to make this resource public? Yes, we want to make this resource public. Allow public, right? Updating policy. So that policy has been updated, right? So the next thing is we go edit our website configuration. So we go back here on the bucket level, right? You see these three dots here? We click on it. So it tells us edit website configuration. We click on it. So we're going to add an index page and an error page, right? Index page is the default page that it serves when people go to that URL. So we designed it, right? So maybe I'll show you later. Index page is index dot. If you look at the files in the pages of that static file, you see that there's an index page. So we give this index.html, and then if you look at them again, you see that there's also another one. Error.html. Right? So that's fine. So we save that. There are uses for that. So when you get there, you can read those too, right? So we have that. We've edited our website configuration. The next thing we want to do now is we want to test our website, right? But first, I think I want to refresh this page. Okay, and I think it's okay. Okay, what I wanted to do was get into that bucket. Did I did not get into that bucket? All right. So the next thing is we want to test our website, right? So to test it, we'll grab the public URL of our copy public URL, right? This is kind of the website URL. I will paste that, right? And voila, right? We have a static website up and running, right? So this pretty much it. Now, of course, if you want to customize it, like I said, we started with them customizing it, maybe we'll call this mycomputershop.com. That would have been the name here. The next thing is that you would have registered a domain name, that's mycomputershop.com, and then you verify with Google. Then there's a place where you're going to point your domain name to this storage bucket, right? So then you now have that. So when you now drop that domain name that you've pointed to the storage bucket on the web, you go straight to mycomputershop.com or whatever your domain name is. No need to route it through storage.googleapis.com, right? That's just your bucket, your server, right? So I'm going to drop a link that will show you how to register your domain name using CNAME, right, to configure it properly. But then this is it, right? So we have a static website. It tells what we want people to see. This for this computer shop. They sell software, they sell computers. And then they say, okay, if you want to see us, send us a message, email us, email address, phone number, drop your phone number, then you advertise it, right? So this is a static website and it serves the purpose for this demonstration, right? So thank you very much. Okay, finally, at this level, if you're also practicing on your own side, once you've demonstrated and everything is working, the next thing you want to do is to delete resources, right? So you save cost, right? So you just click this and then you click delete, right? So if I click delete, it's going to prompt me, do I want to delete it? And then it's going to delete it. But for now, I don't want to delete it. I'm going to leave it open so that for a little while so that people can go and click and see what we demonstrated, right? So thank you very much. If you like this tutorial, feel free, like and share, right? And if you have questions or comments, do drop it for me in the comment section. I will respond to you. So once again, my name is Ugochukwu Ukwebu. I'm a cloud engineer. Thank you and see you next time. Bye-bye.